The beautiful Drakenstein Valley lies about 60 kilometers east of Cape Town on the Berg River. Paarl is the third oldest colonial settlement in South Africa. Today it's home to a very culturally diverse community. The average temperatures are in winter 14 degrees Celsius and summer 29 degrees. Paarl Mountain was declared a nature reserve in 1977. Paarl is particularly known for this mountain, or Paarl Rock. Wellington was once known as Valley of the Wagon Builders. Today there are very few reminders of that industry. Butterfly World is a paradise for butterflies. In a closed garden environment, they fly freely around as you take a stroll through their world. Drakenstein Lion Park was established in 1998. Feeding times are on Monday, Wednesday and Friday at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. The park is actively involved in improving the quality of life of lions in captivity. Le Bonheur Crocodiles. Every half an hour, a guided tour leads you across open dams via rampways. Over 1,000 crocs are housed in these dams. Visitors have an opportunity to touch and hold a baby croc, and during summer months, they will have the opportunity to witness feeding. Just 3 kilometers outside Paarl lies Helmut Filderer Distillery. Helmut, a successful restaurateur from Germany, is the first producer of high-quality grappa and eau de vie in South Africa. The home of Fairview Wines is a 300-hectare farm on the southwest-facing slopes of Paarl Mountain. An old maturation cellar has been converted into a casual Mediterranean-styled eatery called the Goat's Head. There is a resident herd of 600 goats, some of whom like to soak up the sun on the goat tower in front of the winery. Red Hot Glass is one of the very few Venetian-style glass-blowing studios in South Africa. Artists Liz Lacey and David Jackson amaze and delight visitors as they create magnificent glass art, demonstrating their mastery of one of the oldest crafts on earth. Known simply as the Taal Monument, or Afrikaans Language Monument, the most famous Afrikaans icon sits near the top of Paarl Rock, erected in 1975 to celebrate the 100 years after the Society of True Afrikaners was established to stand up for Afrikaans. Paarl is a gourmet's idea of heaven. There are numerous restaurants dotted around the town, where you can really enjoy a lunch or dinner with everything from genuine kapsokos, Cape food, right up to Michelin star style haute cuisine. The Paarl Dutch Reformed Congregation is the third oldest congregation and the oldest church in South Africa, and it's still in use in its original state. The congregation of the Strooidakkerk, literally thatched roof church as it's generally known, is an active, dynamic, spiritual congregation. Het Gesticht was built in 1813 to provide slaves with a place of worship. From 1820 onwards, the congregation became known as the Zion Church. Het Gesticht is the fourth oldest church building in South Africa and is located in Main Street, close to the Strooidakkerk. The streets of Paarl are filled with historic buildings and many galleries dedicated to many facets of the visual arts, from painting to sculpture to ceramics. The purpose of the Afrikaans Language Museum was originally to pay tribute to the people who played such an important role in the process of getting Afrikaans recognized as an official language. The theme of Paarl Museum is the history of Paarl. This museum allows an in-depth look at the town's rich and varied cultural heritage. This starts with early man, Homo erectus, through the later indigenous Khoisan populations and deals with the changes brought about by colonization and including slavery. Ikwezi Community Center has an aim to assist and empower disadvantaged women and children and to address the high unemployment rate and poverty by producing arts and crafts. Chipper's Place offers a true African experience in the heart of the Boerland. This ethnic restaurant with butchery and indoor braai area offers visitors the opportunity to experience African dishes such as tripe and traditional barbecue dishes. The Paarl Bird Sanctuary was established within the Paarl Waste Water Treatment Works. The sanctuary itself contains five large shallow ponds with islands. 140 species have been recorded with a predominance of water birds. With unparalleled amenities, Pearl Valley's signature golf estate and spa offers spectacular views, is bordered by the Berg River and surrounded by the Groot Drakenstein, the Klein Drakenstein and Simmonsberg mountains. The estate philosophy is centered on family living with many child-friendly facilities, including a state-of-the-art lifestyle center, which opened early in 2006. A typical Jack Nicklaus design, Pearl Valley is an 18-hole par 72 golf course. At Drakenstein Prison, a large bronze statue of Nelson Mandela stands as a symbol of the sacrifice of all political prisoners imprisoned under apartheid. The KWV Wine Emporium offers visitors a unique opportunity to taste a selection of prestigious wines and brandies. The tours start with an audio-visual presentation of the KWV and its various brands. A specialized tour guide will take visitors through a barrel maturation cellar, then to the world-renowned cathedral cellar and the five big vats. The tour ends with an informal tasting. Life is full of ironic yet fortunate twists. Just ask Rennie Hildenbrand of Hildenbrand Wine and Olive Estate and Klein Rehboxkloof Guesthouse outside Wellington. Experience a game drive through unique fynbos and enjoy exclusive personalized attention. In the heart of the Drakenstein, where one seldom finds such serenity and calm spaces, lies Bontebok Ridge Reserve, Wellington. This is part of the Renosterfeld Conservancy in the Limietberg Valley. Bastiaanskloof Resort is situated in the historic and picturesque mountain pass of Beenskloof. Completed in 1853, the pass was designed and built by Andrew Geddes Bain. The area is ideal for environmental workshops in that it is relatively unspoilt, has a rich fynbos complement, has the Witte River, is well managed and has easily accessible spacious accommodation facilities. Wellington is now home to some of South Africa's finest brandy woods. There are five pot still brandies being produced in Wellington, as well as some very fine grappa. The producers have perfected the art of brandy distillation. Wellington Leather Novelties is modeled on the Italian concept, where these small factories produce an exclusive range of shoes that can be purchased on the premises. A large selection of leather items is offered for sale. Browse and select anything from a keyring to a briefcase. Wellington Museum features not only the cultures of various African ethnic groups, but also prides itself in having ties with countries as far afield as America, England, Scotland, France, and the Netherlands. The museum also exhibits Stone Age artifacts, a major collection of Egyptian artifacts, and exhibits of various pioneers who made their mark on the history of Wellington and South Africa. The Wellington Wine Walk is a 3 or 4 day hiking trail through the beautiful Wellington Valley. It takes you through indigenous fynbos, vineyards, orchards and olive groves. If you love the outdoors, wine tasting and you love to walk, we have superb holiday options for you. Here are some of the other places of interest around the Drakenstein region. Gouda is a small village 15 kilometers west of Tulbagh near Volley Dam. The Parrot's Den pub in the Gouda Hotel is a living museum dating back to 1875. In Hermon you'll find Bartholomew's Klip, a luxury country house located on a 19,000 acre private estate only 75 minutes drive from Cape Town. Ideal for guests looking for a relaxing retreat on the edge of the Drakenstein, you can spend the day under the oak trees, on the dam, or exploring the farm before setting off on an evening game drive. In 1848, Johannes Heinrich Kulpmann of the Rhenish Mission Society bought the farm Leeuwenklip in order to establish a mission station to serve the freed slaves and indigenous inhabitants of the area. The mission statement was named Saren, which is of biblical origin, meaning flats or plain. The population steadily increased into the 20th century, and Saren was officially proclaimed a town on the 19th of December 1929. Saren recently gained municipal status, and the Saren local authority was established. The Drakenstein region is a region of plenty and is waiting to be discovered by the discerning visitor. Make sure you take the opportunity not to miss it.